Hello guys, welcome to Rallis Explained. In today's video, we will explore another aspect of the war in Ukraine, as we already did in one of the previous videos, but this time our interest is the long-term impact on Russia's high-speed rail system. We will delve into how Russia made a mistake and failed to do a technology and know-how transfer, like for example China, leading to a dependence on external suppliers that is now affecting their operations. You may be surprised to learn that Russia has its own HSR line that utilizes the impressive Sapsan trains manufactured by Siemens. These high-speed trains operate on a 650 km railway line connecting Moscow and St. Petersburg. Along most of this route, trains can reach speeds up to 200 km per hour, while certain sections allow for even 250 km per hour. Now let's recall what qualifies as a high-speed line. According to the UIC, high-speed rail lines are defined as railway lines that can accommodate high-speed trains operating at a minimum speed of 200 km per hour for upgraded conventional lines and 250 km per hour or higher for purpose-built high-speed lines. As such, the Moscow-St. Petersburg Railway falls into the first category and is officially recognized as an HSR line. It's worth noting that this line is a double track and was, at the time of its construction, the longest double track railway in the world. The gauge used is 1524 mm, also known as Russian gauge, and the system is electrified with a 3 kV power supply. Since 1984, the railway has been served by Estonia 200 EMUs, which were the first Soviet EMUs designed to operate at speeds of up to 200 km per hour. The ER-200 trains cover the distance between Moscow and St. Petersburg in an impressive 4 hours and 50 minutes. Considering the age of the existing trains and the technological gap in high-speed train production within the Russian Federation, the decision was made to collaborate with Siemens. Siemens was awarded manufacturing HSR trains for the Moscow-St. Petersburg line, and this is where the story of today's video truly begins. In April 2005, a significant event took place with the presence of Russian President and German Chancellor. The heads of Russian Railways and Siemens signed an agreement for the joint development and production of 60 electric trains based on the ICE trains, capable of reaching a maximum speed of 300 km per hour. The contract's value was estimated at 1.5 billion euros, and the plan was to manufacture the trains in Russia through a specially created joint venture. However, as management changes occurred within RŽD, the contract parameters underwent substantial revisions. By May 2006, the number of trains to be purchased was reduced to only 8, and the contract amount was lowered to 600 million euros. Furthermore, the original plan of producing the trains in Russia was abandoned. The revised contract outlined the supply of 8 Velaro high-speed trains by the end of 2010, along with a 30-year maintenance agreement or a minimum mileage of 14 million kilometers. In fact, the supply contract was valued at 276 million euros with an additional 354.1 million euros allocated for maintenance. The contract specified two types of trains to be delivered. 4 single-system trains operating on a direct current with a voltage of 3 kV, referred to as EVS-1, designed for the St. Petersburg-Moscow line. And another 4 dual-system trains capable of operating on 3 kV DC and 25 kV 50 Hz, referred to as EVS-2, intended for the St. Petersburg-Moscow-Nizhny Novgorod line. These Siemens trains for Russia were based on the standard Velaro platform, which had been previously used for trains in Spain and China. However, the Velaro-Russia trains had several structural differences. For instance, the air intakes were positioned on the roof, and the trains were designed to withstand extreme temperatures ranging from -40 to +40 degrees Celsius. Additionally, the interior of this train was almost 30 cm wider than the standard European trains. Each 10-car train set had a length of 250 meters and could accommodate 556 passengers. With a traction power rating of 8,000 kilowatts, the trains achieved a maximum speed of 250 km per hour with the potential for future upgrades to reach 300 km per hour. The trains were equipped with Russia's national train control system and their servicing and maintenance were conducted at the Siemens depot in St. Petersburg. The trains operating on the Moscow-St. Petersburg route was branded as Sapsan, which means Peregrine Falcon. The four single-voltage EVS-1 trains began servicing passengers at the end of 2009, while the dual-system EVS-2 trains commenced operations on the Nizhny Novgorod route in 2010. Sapsan made its mark in the history of the Russian railways in May 2009, when it set the record for the fastest train in Russia, reaching a speed of 290 km per hour. The introduction of Sapsan proved to be a resounding success, evidenced by the continuously growing number of passengers opting for this high-speed train service. Then, in December 2011, RŽD placed an order with Siemens for an additional 8 Sapsan trains, costing approximately 600 million euros including maintenance. These trains were delivered between December 2013 and the end of 2014. In 2014, plans were announced to replace the Sapsan trains on the Moscow-Nizhny Novgorod line with Algo 250 trains manufactured in Spain. The decision to replace the Sapsan trains on this line was partly driven by the need to increase the frequency of trains on the Moscow-St. Petersburg line. Additionally, technical limitations prevented the Velaro train from achieving speeds higher than 160 on the Nizhny Novgorod route. During the operation of the Sapsan trains, several incidents occurred involving collisions with individuals crossing the railway tracks. In the first year alone, more than 20 people lost their lives in such accidents. Despite efforts to improve safety measures between 2010 and 2011, such as the construction of fences along the railway right-of-way, the installation of signaling systems on pedestrian crossings, and even the presence of guards, the number of accidents involving high-speed trains remained high. Also, a lot of other train services were cancelled to provide enough capacity for Sapsan trains, adversely affecting interregional travel. Traveling from Moscow to cities on the Moscow-Petersburg line became increasingly difficult, such as Vyshny Volochok, Bologoe, Okulovka and others, without relying on the Sapsan trains. However, the trip cost on the Sapsan was 4 to 5 times higher than the cancelled train services, which caused great dissatisfaction among the users of cancelled trains. Furthermore, to accommodate the infrastructure needs of high-speed trains, freight trains had to be rerouted, resulting in increased transportation distances from 660 to 1100 km and also higher costs for transported goods. The increasing number of passengers transported by Sapsan trains surpassing 5 million people in 2017 clearly indicated the growing demand. Consequently, plans were set in motion to plan and construct another dedicated high-capacity railway to St. Petersburg. In 2019, RŽD placed a third order for 13 high-speed Sapsan trains from Siemens and Ural Locomotives, a joint venture between the Sinara Group and Siemens AG. The order had a total value of around 1.1 billion euros, including the supply of 13 trains worth 513.5 million euros and a 30-year service agreement worth 583.1 million euros. This third batch of trains was intended to consist of Class EVS-1 units, bringing the total number of Sapsan trains to 29. However, following Russia's attack on Ukraine in February 2022, Siemens announced in March 2022 that it had suspended the contract and would not deliver the remaining trains. Additionally, Siemens announced plans to leave Russia after more than 170 years of operations as part of its response to Russian invasion. The estimated cost of this exit was around $660 million, primarily due to the loss of future sales in rolling stock and train maintenance. The undelivered Sapsan trains were considered for potential handover or sale to countries like Kazakhstan, Ukraine, or the Baltic states with similar operating conditions. Siemens had also established a network of depots in Russia to maintain and repair Sapsan and Lastochka trains. However, the company announced the termination of all maintenance contracts for this equipment on May 2022. In response, RŽD stated that they would continue servicing the trains independently within the framework of Russian legislation. We found information that in December 2022, RŽD reported that they had component reserves to last for 12 to 18 months and Russian-made replacements were already being tested. Given the advanced technology of the Sapsan trains, which are considered around 20 years ahead of what Russia is capable of producing, concerns were raised about the future condition of these trains. So, concerns were raised about whether these domestically produced parts would meet the necessary standards for safe train operation, as maintenance had previously been carried out by Siemens using Siemens parts. Additionally, Russia faced challenges due to sanctions imposed by Taiwan, a significant producer of semiconductor chips, which could impact the availability of advanced chips required for the trains. Now, RŽD operates 20 Sapsan trains, and surely one of the solutions will be the dismantling of individual train sets that will serve as a pool for spare parts to keep the trains in operation for a certain time. Furthermore, Chinese company CRRC has emerged as a potential candidate to replace Siemens in Russian rolling stock projects. This is partly due to a decrease in order volumes in the Chinese market. While Asian companies have attempted to enter the Russian high-speed rail project before, Siemens managed to secure the contract a few years ago. However, with limited options now available, Russia may need to cooperate with China for its future rolling stock needs. Also, the Sapsan project encountered legal disputes between RŽD and Siemens. The German manufacturer alleged that it could not fulfill the terms and conditions of the contract with RŽD, contrary to the contract itself and clarifications provided by the European Commission. In response, the Commercial Court of Moscow declared Siemens' unilateral termination of the contract with RŽD invalid in February 2023. Furthermore, the court ruled that Siemens would be charged €200,000 daily for the contract's failure. Siemens, of course, filed an appeal against this decision. Subsequently, the Moscow Arbitration Court granted Russian Railways application to collect daily penalties from Siemens Mobility for non-compliance with the court's decision. The arbitration court approved the application and ordered Siemens Mobility to pay a $75,850 penalty for each day of non-compliance with the court judgment. But considering the whole situation, it is very unlikely that Russia will ever collect these penalties. If you enjoyed this exploration of the Sapsan train project and want to stay informed about such intriguing railway topics, we encourage you to subscribe to our channel. You'll be notified of our future videos and also discussions that delve into fascinating railway stories. Additionally, if you would like to support the production of more in-depth content and gain exclusive benefits, we invite you to consider becoming our patron. Once more, we want to express our gratitude to everyone who has watched, and we look forward to having your support as we explore further into the world of railways.